And let's get you first to all the latest numbers with regards to how many cases of coronavirus have been reported in India. The total positive cases at this point stands at 2,004 across the country. Active cases of coronavirus that have been confirmed so far by the government is 1,784. 162 people have recovered from coronavirus in India. Unfortunately, the number of deaths also is rising. 58 deaths have been reported so far due to coronavirus. These are the latest stats as of 8:30 this morning. Let's also tell you exactly how states are faring. Maharashtra still remains the worst affected state with 335 cases of coronavirus. Active cases are at 280. 39 people have recovered from coronavirus in the state. Unfortunately, the death toll is also on the rise in Maharashtra. 16 deaths have been reported due to coronavirus. Meanwhile, in the state of Kerala, 265 cases have been reported of coronavirus. 240 active cases of coronavirus have been confirmed. 2 deaths have also been reported in the state. In neighbouring Tamil Nadu, there's been a spike in the number of cases because of the number of people who attended the event in Nizamuddin. 234 cases of coronavirus, of which 227 are active cases. The number of deaths reported in Tamil Nadu at this point stands at 1. And as we continue getting you all the latest numbers and figures that you need to know on the coronavirus outbreak, here's a look at also the top 5 developments. Tamil Nadu is on high alert after 110 new coronavirus cases in the state have been linked to the Tablighi Jamaat event in Delhi. Officials say that of the total 234 cases of coronavirus in the state, 190 are linked to the Delhi event. Indore has reported 12 new coronavirus cases on Wednesday, bringing the total number of active cases in the state to 80. Indore has now emerged as a coronavirus hotbed in Madhya Pradesh with 76 positive cases. Padma Shri awardee and former Hazuri Ragi at the Golden Temple, Nirmal Singh, has died of coronavirus this morning. The 62-year-old had recently returned from the United Kingdom and was being treated at a hospital in Amritsar. The local police have sealed the residences close to Nirmal Singh's home in Amritsar to ensure the virus doesn't spread. CBSE has directed all its affiliated schools to promote all students from classes 1 to 8. Students studying in classes 9 and 10 will be promoted to the next class on a school-based assessment. The centre has said that PMO-consulted teams are working to ensure that 2 lakh trucks ply on roads to provide essential food and medicine items across the country. As of yesterday, around 1.5 lakh trucks are on roads supplying essential goods. Well, the search is on for the Tablighi Jamaat head, Maulana Saad Kandhalvi, after he was booked for leading a religious gathering in Delhi's Nizamuddin in violation of the government orders. Maulana Saad had made an open call to violate the lockdown orders in the undated audio accessed by India Today. He can be heard exhorting Muslims to assemble for prayers in mosques despite the lockdown orders that are in place. Remember, a Tablighi Jamaat congregation was organized in Nizamuddin from March 1st to 15th, which saw participation of at least 2,000 people, including foreigners. Several positive COVID-19 cases have been found in different states and have links to this congregation, including 24 in Delhi. At least 6 people who had attended the congregation have died of coronavirus in Telangana.
An alarming hotspot of coronavirus infection. A Tablighi Jamaat congregation setting off COVID-19 clusters. India Today shows how it all happened. Our open source intelligence has retrieved provocative speeches of the center's head, Maulana Saad. Tapes that were hidden from public view overnight laid bare for the nation. We have pulled out the YouTube accounts hosting these clips. Listen in. how the Maulana is asking the massive congregation to ignore coronavirus advisories and stay put. Notice how people are coughing in the background as the cleric exhorts them to defy social distancing. You heard Maulana Saad arousing religious passions. You heard him saying social distancing is anti-Islamic. He didn't stop there. These clips were uploaded on YouTube channels Delhi Markaz and the Message of Islam. The tapes suggest that these gatherings and speeches continued as late as March 26, after the national lockdown came into force.
सजा से बचने के लिए या अपने जुर्म की वजह से मुशरिक है कैद करके लाया गया है मुमकिन है कि जान बचाने के लिए भाग जाए तो आपने चोर को और मुशरिक को मस्जिद में बांध कर रखा
आगाह करने के और वार्निंग देने के बावजूद भी
India Today's team also accessed videos of police warning to the Markaz. Take a look at this March 23rd video. Nizamuddin Station House officer Mukesh Walia issuing notice to its representatives for violating the ban on mass gatherings issued by the Delhi government.
तो आप लोगों को बार-बार आगाह करने के बावजूद भी ये चीज समस्या हल नहीं हो रही है। अब मैं आपको जो आपके हाथ में नोटिस है, ये नोटिस आपको दे रहा हूँ और मोहम्मद असाद साहब के नाम पे दे रहा हूँ। इसके बाद भी अगर कोई ऐसी इशू निकला और आप लोगों ने इसको बिल्कुल तुरंत प्रभाव से क्लियर नहीं किया तो मैं बहुत स्ट्रिक्ट लीगल एक्शन के लिए मजबूर हूं
द तबलीगी जमात कांग्रीगेशन बिगन एट द एंड ऑफ फरवरी अटेंडेड बाय अ नंबर ऑफ ओवरसीज विजिटर्स सेवरल स्टेट्स हैव रिपोर्टेड केसेस ट्रेस्ड टू निजामुद्दीन इवेंट But the 55-year-old Maulana himself is untraceable so far. An FIR has been registered against him under the penal provisions. The cleric calls himself the Amir or the head of the Tablighi Jamaat. The congregation he presided over went on despite the Delhi government's restrictions. Heads must roll. With Ankit Kumar, Bureau Report, India Today.
Munish Pandey is now joining us live. He's reporting from outside the Nizamuddin police station in Delhi. Munish, what really is the police doing now to find Maulana Saad? You know, there have been a lot of questions that have also been asked of the police in the investigation into the lapses here. Considering that where you're standing, the Nizamuddin police station is right next to the Tablighi Jamaat.
Yeah, very true, Akshita, and not only Delhi police, but also the government failed to stop this at a right time because remember, On 21st of March, the first advisory was given by the Home Ministry that there were 824 foreign nationals who were at this mosque in Nizamuddin, where I'm standing, and they are in now 15 states. But even after that, there was a meeting on 24th of March. The SHO can be seen in the video directing the authorities of Markaz Nizamuddin that they should evacuate. But there was no force used at that point of time. They were not dealt with strict action, and that is why it took almost 10 days to evacuate everyone. And in result of that time loss, what exactly has happened that 824 national foreign nationals were spread in different mosques in 15 states. There are thousands of people who are Indian national who are also in different states at this point of time. So now it is suspected that it might have initiated a chain reaction, because after they left this mosque, they went in different trains and buses, and then they again stayed in different mosques. So they might have came in contact with several other person, and this is what the scary part is, because in last 24 hours, Akshita, if you see, there are most of the positive cases who are related to this Markaz who attended the gathering from 20th March to 24th of March. So it has become a very serious issue. Also, now the Delhi police is looking into the criminality in this entire case, because Mohammad Saad can be heard telling everyone that they should not listen to the doctor, they should stay inside the mosque. There is not a better place to die.
Munisha, giving us details of that controversial audio that's been released, there's breaking news that's coming in. And Munisha, request you to stay on with us. This is another audio tape that's been released by Maulana Saad now, and in this audio message, he in fact comes out to say that you must support the authorities, you must stay at home. He also claims that he is in isolation. Remember, a manhunt is currently underway to nab him, considering that he's been named in an FIR for that gathering that happened at the Tablighi Jamaat. Listen into this fresh audio tape.
Apne aap ko quarantine kiye hue hai. Ye ehtiyati tadabeer yaqeen tawakkul iman billah ke hargiz khilaf nahi. اس لئے ان تدابیر کا اختیار کرنا ضروری ہے جہاں جہاں بھی ہماری جماعتیں ہیں وہ وہاں رہتے ہوئے حکومت کے قوانین کی پابندی ضرور کریں فقط والسلام بندہ محمد سعد غفر اللہ
السلام علیکم دہلی مرکز کی ہر نئی ویڈیو کی نوٹیفیکیشن پانے کے لیے سبسکرائب کریں دہلی مرکز یوٹیوب
So that is the fresh audio message that's come out from Maulana Saad. This time, completely different from that earlier audio tape. Here, he's asking people to follow and ensure that they stay indoors, that they follow the lockdown orders and cooperate with authorities. A complete U-turn on his previous audio message. Let's listen in once again to this latest one.
Isme koi shak nahi ke is waqt puri duniya mein ye waba hum insano ke gunahon ka natija hai. Is waqt یقینی اسباب میں دعائیں استغفار کی کثرت اللہ کی طرف متوجہ ہونے اور انفرادی عبادات اور اپنے گھروں میں رہتے ہوئے دعوت اور تعلیم کا اہتمام کرنا ہے یہ اللہ رب العزت کے عذاب کو ہٹانے کا اور اس کے غصے کو ٹھنڈا کرنے کا اصل ذریعہ ہے البتہ ظاہری اسباب میں احتیاط اور تدابیر کے اختیار کرنا جس میں خاص طور پر علماء حق کی طرف سے جاری کردہ ہدایات کا اہتمام کرنا ہے نیز ڈاکٹروں کی ہدایات و علاج کا اہتمام حکومت و انتظامیہ کا پورا ساتھ دینا مثلا مجمع جمع نہ کرنا اور ان حالات میں حکومت اور انتظامیہ کی پوری مدد کرنا ضروری ہے بندہ از خود بھی دہلی میں ڈاکٹروں کی ہدایات کے مطابق اپنے آپ کو کوارنٹائن کیے ہوئے ہے یہ احتیاطی تدابیر یقین توکل ایمان باللہ کے ہرگز خلاف نہیں اس لیے ان تدابیر کا اختیار کرنا ضروری ہے جہاں جہاں بھی ہماری جماعتیں ہیں وہ وہاں رہتے ہوئے حکومت کے قوانین کی پابندی ضرور کریں فقط والسلام بندہ محمد سعد غفر اللہ
So that is the audio tape that's just been released. This came out yesterday is what we're told, where you have Maulana Saad saying that people should stay inside, should follow all the orders that are being issued by the authorities with regards to coronavirus. Munish Pandey is also live with us. Munish, the point that will be in fact interesting, or that the authorities will be looking into, is the part where in fact you have the Tablighi Jamaat chief saying that based on doctor's advice, I've quarantined myself, I'm in isolation.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, Akshita, this is a complete U-turn and it is complete bizarre because Mohammad Saad knows at this point of time is that there is a manhunt against him. There is no face saver. He has crores of followers in India and around the world. And now when the police is searching for him, he is releasing a new audio. And what is different is that earlier he was saying that there is no need to follow the advice of the doctor. There is no need to follow the guidelines of the government. And people should, in fact, populate the mosque at this point of time when the coronavirus scare is around the globe. But now in the fresh audio, he has taken a U-turn saying that they should follow the instruction of the government and the doctors. Now the Delhi police will be looking into this audio, but overall it's only a face saver, and at this point of time still there is a manhunt by different teams of Delhi police to locate where Mohammad Saad is so that he can be arrested as soon as possible. Back to you, Akshita.
Okay, Monish, stay with us. Let's once again listen in to this fresh audio tape that's become out now of Maulana Saad. Earlier, we had told you how Maulana Saad had told people to go ahead and violate the lockdown. He's completely changed tune now. He's saying, stay indoors, follow what the authorities say about the lockdown.
इसमें कोई शक नहीं कि इस वक्त पूरी दुनिया में यह वबा हम इंसानों के गुनाहों का नतीजा है. इस वक्त यकीनी असबाब में दुआएं, इस्तिग़फ़ार की कसरत, अल्लाह की तरफ मुतवज्जे होने और इंफरादी इबादत और अपने घरों में रहते हुए दावत और तालीम का अहतमाम करना है. ये अल्लाह रब्बुल इज़्ज़त के अज़ाब को हटाने का और उसके गुस्से को ठंडा करने का असल ज़रिया है. अलबत्ता ज़ाहिरी असबाब में एहतियात और तदाबीर के अख्तियार करना, जिसमें ख़ास तौर पर उलमाए हक़ की तरफ से जारी करदा हिदायत का अहतमाम करना है. नीज़ डॉक्टरों की हिदायत व इलाज का अहतमाम, हुकूमत व इंतज़ामिया का पूरा साथ देना, मसलन मजमा जमा न करना और इन हालात में हुकूमत और इंतज़ामिया की पूरी मदद करना ज़रूरी है. जहाँ जहाँ भी हमारी जमातें हैं वो वहाँ रहते हुए हुकूमत के कवानीन की पाबंदी ज़रूर करें.
So that is the latest audio message that's come out. But to really highlight the contradiction here in what he said now and earlier, we're playing out the audio message that India Today accessed of Maulana Saad earlier, in which he had made an open call to violate the lockdown order. Listen into that message.
ये ख्याल बातिल ख्याल है कि मस्जिद में जमा होने से बीमारी पैदा होगी. ये ख्याल बिल्कुल बातिल ख्याल है. मैं कहता हूँ अगर तुम्हें तुम्हारे तजर्बे में ये नज़र भी आ जाए कि मस्जिद में आने से आदमी मर जाएगा, तो इससे बेहतर मरने की जगह कोई हो नहीं सकती. हाय हाय, सहाबा तमन्ना करते थे काश दावत देते हुए मौत आवे, काश नमाज में मौत आवे. इन्हें नमाज में खतरात नजर आ रहे हैं. ये नमाज छोड़कर भागेंगे इसलिए ताकि अजाब हट जाए. अल्लाह अजाब लाए नमाज छोड़ने की वजह से, ये अजाब हटाएंगे मस्जिदों को छोड़ने की वजह से. सोचे तो सही, कैसी उल्टी सोच है. अल्लाह अजाब ला रहे मस्जिदों को छोड़ने की वजह से, ये अजाब हटा रहे हैं मस्जिदों को छोड़ने के जरिए से. सोचे तो सही, कितनी उल्टी सोच है. ये शैतान का वहम और वसवसा है. और जितने अहले बातिल हैं वह ऐसे मौके से फ़ायदा उठाकर कहते हैं कि हम अहले दुनिया हम जानते हैं, तुम मौलवी उलमा क्या जानो बीमारियों का दिफा कैसे होता है, डॉक्टर जानते हैं. नहीं, सिर्फ उस डॉक्टर की राय काबिले कबूल हो सकती है जो डॉक्टर खुद मुत्तकी हो, दीनदार हो, अल्लाह से डरने वाला हो, अल्लाह से डरने वाला हो और अमल का शौकीन और पाबंद हो. वो भी अगर वो ऐसा मशवरा देता है कि जिससे अमल जाए हो तो उस पर भी उसकी बात नहीं मानी जाएगी. जे जाए कि कोई फासिख फाजिर आदमी ये कहे कि मस्जिदों को बंद कर देना चाहिए और मस्जिदों को ताले लगा देने चाहिए, किसी बीमारी बढ़ेगी, इस ख्याल को दिल से निकाल दो.
So that was the first audio message in which you can hear Maulana Saad clearly saying that you should violate the lockdown order, gather in mosques in large numbers and offer prayers. Now a new audio tape in which he says that people should follow the lockdown orders, should stay at home and heed what doctors have to say. Taking this once again across to Munish Pandey, who's joining us live from Nizamuddin in Delhi. Munish, what's interesting is also the timing of this particular audio tape. This fresh one was issued yesterday and is perhaps also giving Maulana Saad an excuse not to join the investigation because he's saying, I've also isolated myself.
Yeah, well, Akshita, if you look at the timeline, time and again, the Markaz authorities have been lying to the police because, remember, initially they said that there were only 1,000 people inside the Markaz and they are following the guidelines. Then yesterday we saw that more than 2,361 people were rescued from this very mosque in Nizamuddin. Apart from that, they said that they are following the guidelines. But in the audio earlier, which we accessed, which India Today accessed, he can be heard saying there is no need to follow the advice of doctor. There is no need to follow the guidelines of government as far as coronavirus is concerned. And also, he went on to saying that there is nothing known as social distancing in Islam and every person should come and populate the mosque. But now in the new audio, he has released only after an FIR has been lodged and he has taken a U-turn from his earlier statement. And he is a person who is followed by crores of Indians and not only in India but around the world. More than people of seven foreign nationals were present in inside the mosque at that point of time. More than 2,000 people were present when this speech was being delivered, where he's saying that flout the guidelines of the government. So it has become very serious, and that is why this new audio has been issued by the Delhi police. Remember, he is claiming that he is in isolation, but the very same time, police is trying to reach him. They have requested through media that he should come out and present himself before the law, but he is not coming out. Instead, he is releasing the audio tape. So we can assume that he is doing only because now he is under pressure by the police and government authorities to surrender before the law so that a criminal action can be initiated against him.
Yes, and we will be closely tracking the investigation by the authorities. They're no doubt going to be analysing this particular audio tape and try to find out exactly where Maulana Saad is. He claims that based on doctor's advice, he's quarantined himself. Munish, thank you for joining us with all.
Hello everyone, this is Rahul Kamal here. Hope you enjoyed this video. For the latest news and analysis, like and subscribe the India Today YouTube channel and don't forget to press the bell icon to stay updated.